Let's get to the final trade of the day. Joining us for that is Tim Biggum of Delta Derivatives. Tim, always good to have you here.
Hello, Ange.
You tend to use the straddle option strategy when trading earnings. So tell us more about your approach.
Yeah, it's actually called the expected move. So you look at the nearest term at the money straddle, which is the call and put both. For example, if Apple's at 190, you'd look at the 190 call and put, see what the combined price gives as far as a percentage move. That's what the option market kind of predicts as a move on earnings. Then I will take a look and say I either disagree or agree with that, structure my trade based on that. So I'd like to also come in after earnings if there's been an earnings torpedo on a stock that I like that I think's a kind of a one-time event, and come in and sell puts to be a buyer at lower levels. So kind of a two-pronged attack on earnings season going forward.
Tim, using a straddle gives you upside and downside exposure to your earnings plays. That has to come in handy because sometimes we do see those big outsized moves.
Yeah, absolutely. When you buy a straddle or buy a strangle, which is a little further out on either side, you're looking for a big move, really don't care which direction. Of course, you can come in and sell that as well if you think that the market's overpricing the risk here. I would always be, spread on that sort of trade to find my risk so you don't have that unlimited loss.
Thank you as always, Tim. We always appreciate your trader talk.
You bet, Ange.
For more Business First AM, check us out on social media. We're on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter. And go to businessfirstam.com for where to see our show on TV.